Good morning, Northport. Today, we are going to be talking about air masses. Air masses are, in this class, referred to as parcels of air that have similar physical characteristics with respect to temperature and humidity. If we have a large mass of air moving across the planet, being transported by planetary winds, that mass of air has a certain temperature, which is an average kinetic energy, and humidity, which is moisture content. If you remember, we talked about absolute humidity, which is the total amount of water in that air, and relative humidity is how much water that is in the air relative to how much it can hold. Cold air holds less water. Warm air holds more water. So if you look at the map over here, air that comes from the north, the higher latitudes, tends to be drier, and air that comes from the south that's warm tends to contain more moisture. Remember, in the winter is when you have to use chapstick and your skin dries out. Okay, so labeling air masses. Just like climate, what we do is we describe it with respect to temperature and humidity. Air masses are labeled based on temperature and humidity, which are determined by their source region. Now, source region is a location where the air mass has spent a considerable amount of time. The planetary winds have slowed down, and it was able to pick up characteristics from that region. For instance, if an air mass is in the north up here at a high latitude for an extended period of time, the angle of insulation is less from the sun, the temperatures are less, and you get cooler air masses forming. If there's an air mass that's down closer to the equator, what's going to happen is it's going to increase in temperature due to the electromagnetic energy coming from the sun strikes the earth absorbs it, re-radiates it as long infrared, and it heats the lower atmosphere, the troposphere. So down here we have air masses forming that are warm, and up here we have air masses that are forming cold. Now the second physical characteristic is humidity, whether or not there's a high moisture content or low. That's going to be dependent on whether or not it forms over land, where it has nowhere to draw moisture from, or if it forms out over one of the oceans. Now remember, throughout its life, air masses can change physical characteristics. If there's an air mass whose source region is up north and it travels down to the south, and then winds die down for an extended period of time, that air mass could become warm. Then if it travels back up to the higher latitudes, it will bring that warm air with it. So air masses can change. So when air slows down or stalls, just like a car when it stops running, in an area it will pick up similar characteristics to that region. Now when we label an air mass, what we do is we use a chart. Let's see, where is that? Here, this little box is for air masses. And when we describe air masses, we need two letters. Just move this over. What it's going to be is one from this group and one from this group. One is going to describe humidity and the other one's going to describe temperature. A C is for continental, M is for maritime. Okay, continental is going to be dry, meaning formed over a continent. M is going to be maritime, and that's humid, formed over water. So when describing an air mass, just like describing a climate, we're going to pick one of these letters, C or M. Down here, we have polar versus tropical. Polar is cold, like the North Pole, South Pole. and the tropics between 23.5 north, 23.5 south is going to be warm. So they're formed at low latitudes near the equator. Okay, so these four right here are combinations of these two groups. Okay, so when you describe an air mass, you pick a letter from here, letter from there, and there's one other case that they added recently on the reference table. I say recently, it was probably like 10 years ago, but continental Arctic, and that's extremely cold air that holds very, very, very little water, and it's very dry. Okay? So, now what we do is we go over here. If you look at this map, if you have an air mass that stalls over central Canada, it's right in the middle of the continent, it's going to be dry, so we use C. And then this is pretty far north. It's at a high latitude. It's cold most of the year, so that's going to be polar. So we take the C from this, the P from that, and CP is describing the temperature and humidity of our air mass. If you have an air mass that forms down over the Gulf of Mexico is a body of water, so it's going to pick up humidity, and this is maritime. By the way, water evaporates for energy from the sun. Evaporation increases during the summer months with increased average kinetic energy. Okay. The other method by which water evaporates was transpiration, if you remember, with the trees. Okay, so over the Gulf of Mexico, we got maritime, humid, and tropical because it's close to the equator. And this air mass, as planetary winds carry it north over the central United States, it's going to bring that moist tropical air with it. And that's why you live in different locations and you experience different weather, because these air masses move around the surface of the continent, and once again they're moved by uneven heating of the earth and planetary winds, which we'll be doing in the near future. Okay, hopefully that made sense, and I'm going to give you some worksheets to try out those skills.